Bob, you've been involved in this game a long, long time. What do events like this, how did these, you know, inspire you again to see this horde of media out here for this, you know, huge event?
Well, obviously this event has captured everybody's imagination, and that's great. And, you know, there's an old cliche that high tide raises all boats. So I think the attention that this event is getting helps everybody in the sport of boxing.
You've been involved in both of these legendary fighters' careers. You initially promoted Floyd Mayweather, now, of course, promoting Manny Pacquiao. What do you think about their status right now? How do you handicap this fight going into it, knowing that you're the promoter for Pacquiao, but what are your views on the fight itself taking place now?
Well, Floyd obviously is an excellent fighter. The years that he fought under our banner, he was tremendous, and he continued to excel. He's one of the best defensive fighters that I've seen. He also has a very, very good right-hand punch, which he uses to pick off his opponent. If anything, his legs may have slowed up a little bit, so he's more stationary, which makes for a more exciting fight. As far as Manny is concerned, the truth is, I don't think his legs have slowed. I've seen him training where he's faster than I've ever seen him. Now, how that could be, I don't know, but that's what, you know, what I'm seeing. And Manny's style is aggression, and he throws a lot of punches, and it'll certainly outfire Floyd, and the punches have to land. So Manny has to also be careful, so Manny can win this fight with controlled aggression. And that's important. He can't go in like a lunatic. Floyd is technically superb, because Floyd otherwise would pick him off.
30 years ago today, Marvin Hagler against Thomas Hearns, a fight in which you were very intimately involved, of course. You're very keen to point out you can't compare fights over eras. And Hearns and Hagler, to promote this fight, their fight, 20 different press stops, I think, they did together. They hated each other at the end, didn't they? Very different the way you have to approach this fight.
When Marvin fought Tommy, we started, we had never done before. We had two planes. We went west and then east. And in less than 2 weeks, we made 23 cities. So Hagler particularly was an intense guy. And Hearns started, who's the nicest guy in the world, started really grating on Hagler's nerves. So I'll never forget it. We're in St. Louis in Stan Musial's restaurant, and Hearns said something totally innocuous. Hagler went crazy, jumped over a table, and here I was, a little younger, but still no matter. I'm jumping between them, yelling like an idiot, "You keep fighting, you're not getting paid."
Are you surprised at all by the attack that Floyd Mayweather has taken in the promotion of this fight? A little more subdued, a little more laid back, not engaging in the trash talking we've seen in the past. What's your assessment of that behavior?
I think both fighters respect each other, and Floyd is aware of how big this event is, and he is conducting himself accordingly. Floyd, a lot of his trash talking has been done to sell tickets and to hype up the event, which he's a master at. Obviously, this event doesn't need that. So Floyd is, you know, generally a nice guy. The 10 years or so he was with us, I had no problems with him. He always showed up on time. And he's a nice fellow. So I think this is the real Floyd Mayweather that you're seeing now. And the loudmouth guy shooting his mouth off, that was, I think, for show.
As much as we all, you included, wanted this fight to happen 5 years ago, do you think in hindsight that it's bigger and better, more of an event, more of a fight now for that delay?
There is no question that the fight now is much bigger than it would have been 5 years ago. Not necessarily saying it will be a better fight than it would have 5 years ago. But remember, because there's back and forth and insults and everything, for 5 years helped to build up the anticipation for this fight, and obviously it made it so much bigger than it would have been 5 years ago.
When you look around at the promotion these media days and in this world now of social media and technology, the way it's evolved, and all of the major fights that you've been involved with, how does this differ, and what does it compare to, if anything, in terms of just the way it's transcended the entire sport?
You got to understand, I've been in this business since the mid-60s. And in 1971, I was involved in the first Ali Frazier fight. The whole country stopped because it was a political issue. There was Ali, who had opposed the Vietnam War, wouldn't serve, sat out 3.5 years where he couldn't fight because of his principle. And by that time in 1971, the country was waking up to the fact that the Vietnam War was ridiculous. Poor Frazier was labeled being pro-war, which he wasn't. But that created a whole cultural discussion. So the morning of that fight, everything stopped in the United States and around the world because of the anticipation. Unfortunately, the technology was what we would consider now primitive. We had only closed circuit. We could only reach 400 locations because there were no satellites, so it was telephone company long lines. So a small number of people could actually watch that fight live. But if that fight were held today, or that fight was held then with the technology we have now, would it have been better, bigger than this fight? I would have to say yes.
As big as this fight is, and it's going to be in the United States anyway, give us a sense of what this is going to mean in the Philippines.
What?
Give us a sense of how big this fight is, what it's going to mean in the Philippines.
Well, obviously, Manny is the icon in the Philippines, and so everything will stop in the Philippines. But that's been true for every one of his fights. Even the guerrillas who fight in the southern Mindanao province take a truce through when he fights. Everybody watches. There's no crime. Zero crime. There's nobody in the streets. So obviously the Philippines will be glued. And remember, there are 90 million Filipinos in the Philippines, and there's another 15 or 16 million Filipinos around the world, including 7 million in the United States. So in communities all over the world, whether it's Hong Kong or Abu Dhabi or Dubai or England or Israel, the Filipinos, you know, are thousands, and they'll be all, you know, staying up every all hours to watch the fight.
What's the biggest thrill you still get this stage of your career in doing what this is? Because this can't be easy, and obviously negotiating this fight was definitely not easy, Bob. What makes you wake up in the morning and say, you know what, I still get a kick out of this stuff?
Well, I get a kick out of it because I really have become attached to Pacquiao. Manny, I look at his family, and this is a fight that he's wanted for many, many years. And to be able to deliver that fight gives me a lot of satisfaction.
Has there ever been, of all the fighters that you have promoted, anyone even remotely like Manny Pacquiao in terms of his character? He's this very quiet, unassuming, happy-go-lucky guy who's an icon in his home country. He's a congressman. He's a singer, quote-unquote, as well as a great fighter.
Well, is nobody anyone you relate quite to? Like Manny. But as far as character is concerned, two of the fighters that had great character, a lot of them did, but super, was of course Muhammad Ali, who to the public was braggadocious, but when you were with him, was caring and compassionate, and of course, Big George Foreman in his second career.
So, Bob, we have got a few minutes before Manny gets limbered up and gets into the to ring to do his thing. What's on tap for you for the next 2.5 weeks here as we head to fight time? Are tickets actually going to be made available, or what's happening with that?
Well, I talked with Bill Hornbuckle a while ago. Hopefully, by the end of the week, we'll see. I mean, there are not going to be many tickets available to the public, but it's going to be a great, great night, great, great event. I'm looking forward to it. I'm off now for the Dallas, Texas. We have Terrence Crawford fighting this weekend. And then I'll be back at the old grind starting Monday, but it's fun. And I'm so delighted to see Manny in the shape that he is mentally and physically. And I assume Floyd is the same. So it should be a wonderful, wonderful event.
I know all fans are delighted that the fight is finally taking place. Top Rank's Bob Arum joining us here at Manny Pacquiao's Media Day. Thank you very much, Bob, and all the best to you.